Good morning, my dear children. Welcome back to our maths class. In today's video, we are going to revise chapter number 4, subtraction. We will revise the chapter page wise. Okay, shall we start? Yes. So, subtraction means taking away a number from another number. So, we'll start from page number 39. In page number 39, first we have the properties of subtraction, where there are three properties given. The first one is, in subtraction, the bigger number should be first and then the smaller number should be the next. That's the first one. The second property, subtracting 0 from a number. So, what happens when we take away 0 from a number? So, as we all know, 0 means nothing. So, if we take away 0 from any number, we get the same number as the answer. For example, 23 minus 0 is 23. The next one is subtracting 1 from a number. What happens if we take away 1 from any number? So, if we need to take away 1 from any number, we need to find out the previous number. So, the previous number of this number is 43. So, 44 minus 1, we need to take away 1 from this number. So, we need to find out the previous number, the before number of this. So, the before number is also called as the predecessor. So, 44, before number is 43. So, next, moving on to page number 40, we have two-digit subtraction without borrowing or regrouping. So, for two-digit subtraction, we have first 1's place and then the 10's place. First, we need to subtract and write the number in 1's place and then move on to 10's place, subtract the number and write the answer. So, this is about the two-digit subtraction without borrowing. Moving on to page number 41, we have one digit and two digit numbers being subtracted from three digit numbers. This is also without borrowing. So, we have ones, tens and hundreds and we are subtracting one digit from here. So, since we have only one number which is 4, we are writing it in ones place and then subtract and write the answer. 4 minus 4 is 0. If we take away the same number, we get 0 as the answer. Since we don't have any numbers here, we just have to write the same number here for the answer. The same way for subtracting two-digit numbers here. So, ones, tens and hundreds. So, we have 25 here. So, ones, 5 in ones place and 2 in tens place. So, we need to first subtract the 1's place and then write the answer. And then the 10's place, 4 minus 2 is 2. So, we are writing here. Since we don't have any number here, we have to write the same number here down.
Now, next, moving on to page number 42 and 43, where we have subtraction of 2 3 digit numbers. So, we have 1's, tens and hundreds, we have 2 3 digit numbers. This is also without borrowing. So, we just have to start from the ones place. 4 minus 3 is 1 and then moving on to tens place, 8 minus 1 is 7 and hundreds place, 6 minus 2, 4. So, we don't have any borrowing or regrouping here. We just have to subtract the numbers in the respective place value and then write the numbers down. Next, moving on to page numbers 44, 45 and 46, where we have subtraction of numbers with regrouping or borrowing. So, what do you mean by regrouping or borrowing? We don't have a bigger number on the top, so we need to borrow from the next tens place. So, let us see how to do that. So, we have ones, tens and hundreds. We have three-digit number here and we need to subtract this one-digit number from this. So, 7 minus 8. So 8 is the bigger number, so we have more on the floor. So go next door, which is the next place value from tens. So what we are doing here is we are regrouping the tens. Okay, so what should we do? We don't have a bigger number here, so we cannot take away 8 from 7. So what we are doing, we are borrowing 1 ten from here. In tens place we have 9 tens, so we are taking away 1 ten from here. So if we take away 1 ten from here, this will become 8. So we are taking 1 tens to this ones place. So this 1 ten and then 7 becomes 17. So we need to subtract 8 from 17. So after 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. So we are getting 9 as the answer. And then since we have taken away 1 from here, we have 8 tens here, which we have to write. We don't have any number here to subtract, so we need to write the same number here. So next is the subtraction of 2-digit numbers from a 3-digit number with regrouping or borrowing. So first we need to start from the ones place. In ones place we have 4 here, and then we need to take away 5 from here. So we need to borrow 110 from here. So we'll borrow, take away 110 from here. So this will become 2 tens, and then we will get 110 from here to ones. So 110 and then 4 ones together becomes 14. So from 14 we need to take away 5. So after 5 we need to count till 14. So after 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. So 9 is the answer here. So here we have 2 minus 2 is 0, and we don't have any number to subtract here, so 9 we have to write it down here. Now let us move on to page numbers 47 and 48, where we have subtraction of numbers with regrouping of hundreds into tens and ones. So we have 740 minus 79. So first we need to start from the ones place. In ones place we have 0 minus 9. So we cannot take away 9 from 0. So what we need to do is that we need to borrow 1 from tens place. So if we get 1 from here, this will become 3 tens, and then we'll get 1 more here. So we'll get 10 ones. So 10 minus 9 will be 1. So here it will become 3. So we cannot take away 7 from 3. So we need to borrow 100 from here. So we will get 10 tens here. So 10 tens and 3 tens will become 13 tens. So 13 minus 7 would be 6. So since we have given 100s here, the 700s will become 600s. So we don't have any number to subtract here. So this 6 we need to write here. So this is how we do the subtraction of this number. Moving on to page number 49 and 50, we have word problems here. So word problems, we will see one example. Sapna had rupees 980. She spent rupees 280 to buy a doll. How much money does she have now? So for word problems, we need to write three statements. The first statement for the first number, and the second statement for the second number, and the third statement is for the answer. So first statement would be how much she had. So Sapna had rupees 980. So the amount Sapna had equals to 980. So second statement is she spent rupees 280 to buy a doll. So the second statement is the amount she spent, which is equal to 280. So we need to find out the difference of these two numbers. We need to subtract 280 from 980. So the last and the final statement would be from the question. How much money does she have now? So the amount remaining, how much money is she having now, equals to 980 minus 280. So we need to do the calculation here and then write the numbers and do subtraction. After that we are getting 700 as the answer. So the answer is Sapna has rupees 700. So this is all about the word problems where we need to write three statements. First statement for the first number and second statement for the second number which we need to take away. And the third statement is for the answer statement. So this is about subtraction chapter. We have finished revising the subtraction chapter. Prepare well for your exam.